Tonight's Teamwork Makes the Dream Work segment features the big three all-stars of poetry. From Connecticut, a socially conscious family man dedicated to uplifting our youth. From West Oakland, California, I know y'all in here, a veteran of not only one, not only two, but five consecutive Verses and Flow seasons. And from Philadelphia, the legendary Tony and Emmy Award-winning star of Deaf Poetry on Broadway, here's Michael Chief Peterson, Prentice Powell, and Black Ice.
The hashtag says, Black Lives Matter. The toe tag says they don't. We've been labeled and tagged. They put bullet holes through the price tags on our lives because to them, we have no value.
I mean, if we did, I wouldn't have to talk to my two sons about choices while they're still young enough to ride in car seats. Driving down the street, trying to explain why we seem to gain more of a voice once we've lost our heartbeat.
So welcome to Black Friday,
where the best things in life are free except air. Nowadays, men are waiting to exhale, too. You know, the cops shot, shoot till we drop, then call for backup instead of an ambulance. There's an amber alert out for common sense, and a bullseye is pressed on the backs of all black men.
But you'd rather press the red dot in your phone and record the red dot aimed at his head instead of calling the Red Cross. Shout out to my man, Cross-Eyed Red, who was shot by the cops at the local Pound Burger. Ironically, the pound button was the last thing he pressed on his phone before being murdered.
And as his blood lines the streets, his bloodline has ceased. You use your bloodline to tag your peeps in a video you posted to Facebook. But it won't matter because cops don't FaceTime. So let's face facts. When it comes to blacks, too many are tagged by the trigger. Maybe more cops should be on Twitter since they love to follow.
And retweet, repeat the plight of the black man. Hashtag
Sean Bell.
Hashtag
Oscar Grant.
Hashtag Eric Gardner.
Hashtag me. P.S. I can breathe.
Hashtag Freddie Gray. Hashtag Amadou.
Hashtag I'm not through. Julian Cardi. Notice he didn't get a hashtag, and he was a U.S. Army vet, but all he gets is an unsolved murder in my memories of identifying my brother's body as they unzipped that black bag and a casket draped in an American flag that they handed my mother before they lowered my brother in the ground. Pound.
Rest in peace, bro.
Pound.
Trayvon Martin.
Pound.
Mike Brown.
Pound. Prince Jones. And I admit, his name I had to Google on my phone because I've never claimed to be an activist or a revolutionary. It's just scary how social media tends to dictate this world's trending topics.
So instead of immortalizing our deaths, I'm trying to immortalize my kids. That's why I post so many pics, because nowadays it seems like our lives really don't have too much value unless you can get them to trend. So I find myself on Instagram scrolling down a little bit and I see a pic that says, Black Lives Matter, but I can't help but reply, Hashtag since when?
Since it won't matter a week later when some football player hits his wife on an elevator and now y'all have something new to post about. Huh. Domestic violence is nothing to joke about, but when the weight of the world is measured by the pound sign, we begin to wonder how many hashtags does it take to fill a coffin?
Black lives only matter during Black History Month, but blacks become history so often we should dedicate a season. Spring showers leads to summer's flowers for the fallen, leaving our hearts as cold as the winter, leaving us as memories.
And you will remember me.
I swear to God you will remember me.
But before I become just another memory, hashtag remember me.
I feel like the only way you know we exist is because our lifelines get posted in your timelines, and because it gives you the option to share,
you can act like you care.
So tell me, do black lives really matter, or will we continue to be considered as the country's cancer? Take a minute.
Think about it.
And then you can hashtag your answer.
That right there, that has to be one of the most powerful pieces and most relevant pieces we've ever heard on this Verses and Flow stage. Give it up again. Wow. Don't touch that remote. Jussie Small is coming back for another one. Keep it locked right here on Verses and...
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more Verses and Flow.
I would love to tell you I am not made of my mistakes, but I am. And because of that, I am a much better man, but I am also my success. I am made of the breath of those who can no longer inhale. I am made of the souls of those who sailed these seas and didn't make it to this country. I am made of what I made. Three beautiful children who will always make me more proud than anything I ever make of myself.
Witness progress in motion at luxuryawaits.com.
That's a wrap on another amazing night of music and poetry. Before we go, let's shout out our Verses and Flow band under the direction of the man Adam Blackstone. Taking us out, the smash hit from the Empire soundtrack, You're So Beautiful. Jussie Smollett, I'm Laz Alonzo, keep flowing.
Come on, y'all. Sometimes you feel insecure. Trust me, babe, I understand. Even with no manicure, just know that I still hold your hand, yeah. Let's go, y'all. You look so good when you're walking by. Sexy comes in every size. Keep wearing that, baby, just like that. You got yourself a new man. If Kanye's workout plan, I call that baby fat. It ain't nothing wrong with that. Cookie smile.
You ain't got no cookie smile, man.
Hair ain't done your makeup free, but you never go out of style. Oh. You look too good to be mad. You got way too much class all up inside them jeans. Woo! You should be happy. Damn, you seen them thick thighs. You been all up inside the cornbread and collard greens. Go ahead, girl, you call me Poppy, and I like it.
Exclusive content, please go to versesandflow.com.
Flow, you're so beautiful. I love you so much.
Remember to download the Verses and Flow app. Type Verses and Flow into the App Store or Google Play.